The New Madrid Fault is the most active seismic area in the country east of the Rocky Mountains. A recently released study raises new questions about the possibility of another major earthquake. WLKY investigative reporter Steve Bergen found not all scientists agree. Steve?
Vicki, while there is disagreement with the findings from the U.S. Geological Survey, what scientists and researchers agree on is that an earthquake like the ones that hit that area more than 200 years ago would be catastrophic. Students at Lincoln Elementary here in Louisville participating in an annual earthquake drill. It's something state officials prepare for year-round.
We treat the earthquake as one of our greatest threats in Kentucky.
And that threat lies in the western part of the Commonwealth. The New Madrid Zone stretches 150 miles from Illinois to Tennessee. A 2009 report funded by the Federal Emergency Management Agency estimated that an earthquake registering 7.7 would damage more than 700,000 buildings, leave 2.6 million households in the dark, and cause nearly 86,000 injuries and deaths.
So New Madrid definitely is active. The question is how active it is.
It's a new study released in January by the U.S. Geological Survey in Pasadena that has shaken things up.
We think that because there is stress continuing to accumulate in the region, there could be a large earthquake in the future.
There is seismic activity all the time along the New Madrid Fault. The last major earthquakes occurred in the early 1800s. Farmland sank, the Mississippi River changed its course, and the Real Foot Lake was formed. Dr. Morgan Page, who spoke to us from California via Skype, co-authored the latest study.
It was much more densely populated than it was 200 years ago, so it would cause quite a bit of impact. And also, seismic waves in the central and eastern U.S. travel much more efficiently through the Earth's crust than they do in a place like California. So these events would be felt for hundreds of kilometers.
Also in 2009, another research group based out of Northwestern and Purdue universities concluded the New Madrid system may be shutting down. One reason Dr. Page and Dr. Susan Huff tackled the issue again. Their report carries the headline, New Madrid Seismic Zone, Not Dead Yet. Huff and Page found past studies erroneously determined that daily aftershocks are a direct result of the earthquakes occurring more than 200 years ago.
If they're aftershocks, they should be decaying in time. Gradually, fewer and fewer aftershocks should be occurring. But what's happening with these small earthquakes is that they don't seem to be slowing down.
It's that Not Dead Yet headline, along with the odds of a major quake, that has caused quite a stir at the Kentucky Geological Survey.
We can't say, yes, there will be an earthquake tomorrow, or it will be in a month from now. What we can do is give percentages. So like the percentage I gave you, we can estimate it's about 7 to 10% over 50 years.
Several earthquakes.
Dr. Jiming Wong of the Kentucky Geological Survey has studied the New Madrid system for more than 20 years. He doesn't think the just released report breaks any new ground.
You talk about 5-10% in the next 50 years that's out there. But based on our study, this number is not reliable. Again, we just don't have enough data.
An impact assessment prepared for FEMA said an earthquake registering 7.7 in the New Madrid zone could result in the highest economic loss of any natural disaster in the history of the U.S. Steve Bergen, WLKY News.